So this is AASHTO T255, T265, determining moisture content of soils and aggregates. When you come in to certify, you're just going to do this procedure with us verbally. We're not going to expect you to actually demonstrate anything, but we're going to show you a few of the steps here just so that you're familiar with them. So we're going to be dealing with T255, drying of aggregate, and T265, drying of soil. In order to run this test, the first thing that you need to know is the tare weight of your container. So a dry, clean container, you will get the tare weight of that on your scale and round it to the nearest tenth of a gram. This soil was derived from our Proctor test, so we took that moisture content, or that wet weight, right away from the Proctor test. But if you are being handed a sample from the field, we have to make sure to get an accurate moisture content on that material. It needs to be sealed so that there is no evaporation. Same with your aggregate. So we need enough sample weight to run an accurate moisture content test. And those sample weights are based, again, on your nominal maximum size. So there is a table in your procedure. You will look at that table, determine what your nominal maximum size is of aggregate or in your soil sample, and get an appropriate sample mass. What you need to remember is that sample mass is based on dry weight. So there is some weight of this that's going to be moisture, so just make sure you have a bit extra. So you'll take your soil or your aggregate, you know your tared weight of your container, you're going to record your wet mass to the nearest tenth of a gram, or our aggregate, record our wet mass to the nearest tenth of a gram. And then we simply place these into a suitable drying apparatus. For aggregate, we can use a controlled or an uncontrolled heat source. Controlled heat source being forced draft oven, ventilated oven, or convection oven. For aggregate, we can also use uncontrolled heat sources. So we can dry this with a hot plate or a microwave. If we're going to be drying it with a hot plate, we need to make sure that we continuously stir the aggregate while it is drying to get uniform drying and we don't break the aggregate down and we don't overheat it. If we're going to deal with a microwave to dry the aggregate needs to be placed in a microwave safe container, heaped and covered with a ventilated lid while we dry it. Soil can only be dried with a controlled heat source, so forced draft ventilated convection oven, and that is it. If we're going to be using the oven to dry these soils or these aggregates, we place them in the oven. We turn the oven on to 230 degrees Fahrenheit, plus or minus 9, and we dry them overnight or as long as we feel it takes to get them initially dry. So to check for constant mass of our materials so that we know whether or not it's dry, we're going to remove them from the oven and we're going to get our initial dry weight of these materials. So the aggregate, we will weigh it, get that dry weight to the nearest tenth of a gram. And the soil, again, weigh it, and get that first dry weight to the nearest tenth of a gram. And then to know whether or not we are truly dry, this is the check for constant mass. So what we have to do is reintroduce these materials to their heat source. So the aggregate, if we were to have dried it in a microwave, we would place it back into the microwave and dry it for an additional 2 minutes. If we were drying it on a hot plate, we would reintroduce it to the hot plate and dry it for 10 minutes. And if we're dealing with the oven, then we will put the aggregate back into the oven for 30 minutes. Soil, all we can use is controlled heat sources, so soil will go back into the oven for 60 minutes for its additional dry time. So we reintroduce them to the heat source, and then we're going to check their mass a second time to calculate constant mass. So after the additional dry time, we will weigh our soil for the second time, round that to the nearest tenth of a gram, weigh our aggregate for the second time and round that to the nearest tenth of a gram. We will then compare our second dry weight with the first dry weight, and what we need to achieve constant mass is less than 0.1% change in those masses. There is an equation available in your manual that you will use to calculate constant mass. So once we are at less than 0.1% change, that is considered constant mass, and our material is considered dry. We then allow it to cool. We get a final dry weight on it once it is cooled. And we use that final cooled dry weight rounded to the tenth of a gram to calculate moisture content, which is wet mass minus dry mass divided by dry mass times 100, rounded to the nearest 0.1%. That concludes moisture content, T255, T265.